This is Benny.
And this is Dhruv. And today we are going to review the trailer of the movie Meet the In-Laws. This is a 2016 Nigerian movie. It's already on Netflix. And if I read the description on IMDb, it says, a Yoruba man proposes to his Igbo girlfriend, but when the news eventually reaches their parents, their reactions aren't exactly what they expected due to tribal prejudice. Rivalry between the two families begins, but the couple are adamant on their love prevailing.
Romeo and Juliet.
Mm-hmm.
Family food.
Right. The director is Ni Akinmolayan. Writer is Rita Onwura. It stars Dayo Amuson, Judith Audu, and Lillian Esoro, and of course many others. So let's check this out. In fact, actually, before we check this out, it kind of reminds me of a few things. It already reminds me of Namaste Wahala. This is another Nigerian movie where it's, I mean, those are people from two different countries altogether, but this is like two different tribes. So this is very intricate to Nigeria. It also reminds me of Love is War, because I know you haven't seen that yet, but I saw it. You know, the movie where the husband and wife were going against each other in politics, and they were from different tribes. And so when malicious things were happening, that mattered a lot, that you are from this tribe and I'm from this tribe. And we kind of also relate as Indians, right? There's so much diversity in India as well, that we know that there's like always some issues, even within the same state, right? So many intricate things. So this will be interesting to see, because it will also teach us like these specific details about Nigeria. The funny thing is, it also reminded me of the Ben Stiller movie, I think, where he was meeting his girlfriend's in-laws or something, which was also funny. Meet the Fockers or something like that. Yeah. We'll see how close or far this is from all that. All right, let's check this out now.
My name is Dapo Ajayi. You're not too flashy, very respectful, typical Yoruba boy. And that's Ifeoma Okoye, Ife. She's an angel. Together we'll make the best couple, because once there's love, nothing else. I mean, not even tribe matters.
Oma Igbo, Nenu Lemi!
Oye Yoruba.
You didn't see Yewande. You didn't see Etune.
Ejike.
You didn't see Yabo.
What about Tumori?
Oh, yeah, Benny. To bring home to me.
We have more eligible Igbo men.
Hello.
Nah.
I'm Tijake.
Nah. Is this you? I can just give you a very good lifestyle. Nah. Okay, tell me. I got to Dubai.
Tijake. Look, if you don't make it now, who's this man?
Baby, Taiwo is greeting you now. Answer her. Yeah. Dalong.
But Dalong, what's up?
I'm fine.
In their family, they all come. Once they touch body, but twins.
I understand that you want to marry my daughter.
Yes, sir.
You will have to come with your family.
Hey, I heard that my future in-laws are here.
Yes.
Hey, you're welcome.
Adelunke.
I am only trying. I am going to slaughter you. You are bent on this Omo Igbo after
what you know that the father did to me.
But what did you do to her for her to start calling you all those names?
Now you go and ask her that.
No, Papa, I'm asking you, what did you do to her?
Over my dead body!
Mommy, I am going to marry Ife. I love Ife and nothing can stop it. I swear, nothing will stop me from marrying Ife.
But that one kid, tell me the texture of your problem.
You know, Papa, your brother, isn't he a human being?
Maybe we should just give up.
What if 5 years down the
then
line?
Then we will fight to the very end.
For this world where we did, I never see anybody where like woman reach Yoruba man. They like woman. Oh. I got to look front. Look.
They were such a cute couple.
They were.
Yeah.
The reaction of the parents. You know, I mean, that fellow, he starts choking.
That's so Indian, right? The melodrama and the heart attack and all that. Like, it's so similar to how it was in India.
True. And, you know, they start running around the room, kind of chasing each other. It's like going to whack. Somebody's going to whack somebody.
Right.
That also is quite Indian. It can go to that extent.
Of course, it is, even in Nigeria, you could see I think it was the girl's father who says that, you want to marry my daughter? Then we need to meet your family. Because, right, again, it's a marriage of families. It's not just a marriage of individuals. Very, very similar to how it is in India. And it also shows how there is this divide. Right, the younger generation doesn't believe in this tribes and stuff, but the older generation does. It kind of also reminds me of Ram Leela, right? Because they were of different tribes and their ancestries were like, they were rival tribes. I think it's the same here as well, that those are rival tribes. And I don't know, we would have to look how far back that rivalry goes and what happened. Like, it depends on what happened in that. But I something so stressful is done with comedy, right?
Oh, yeah. Yes.
It's such a stressful situation to be in for the couple. And for a couple where the families are opposing each other, there is always this question that comes to their mind that, should we give up? Is this really worth it? And so, I mean, I like that they did show that. I think that happens with every couple whose families don't like each other. And then the entry of another guy who's like, I can give you a very good life. Now, that's like how it was in Badrinath Ki Dulhania, right? I think it was really gorgeous guy comes along. Who was he? Siddharth Shukla, right?
Yeah, yeah.
Siddharth Shukla, and he comes along and it's like, maybe I should change my mind. Like, you know, really, like, how much can your love withstand all these things? Like, you know, there will be so much self-doubt, and it just depends on how much you love each other and what your connection is.
True. Actually, I feel the younger you are, I think you take less practical decisions. You would tend to stick to your love, you know, because you're idealistic the younger you are. But as you grow older, I mean, the age that these people, this couple is, they're somewhere in their mid-20s, I would believe. At that age, you know, you become practical, and sometimes you feel like, okay, maybe this is not worth it. Maybe I should go for the guy who is going to give me a good lifestyle, and my parents are also happy with this person, maybe for the best. You know, you tend to fall for such things. But let's see how it goes in the movie. We have no idea what it ends up with. But I'm sure that in the movie, they are going to have a happy ending. Somewhere or the other.
Yeah, because, I mean, just the tone of the movie, you can say that they're struggling. I doubt, very highly doubt that they would show that didn't work out, you know? This is reminding me of so many things. It also reminds me of that Akshay Khanna and
Kareena Kapoor.
Well, that, and also Akshay Khanna and Nagma's sister. I again forget her name.
Jyotika.
That movie was so good because it was their parents' egos and all that, and then they give up. They actually end up giving up in the movie, and then their parents are like, actually, they were a good couple. Maybe we shouldn't have done all that. Like, that was such a fresh perspective on things. So,
true.
You know, it would be,
you know, This reminds me, I had read this article a long time back, and I'm not sure the authenticity of it, but what was written in that article was that previously, before the Europeans went over to Africa, the tribes had, there are small tribes, there are small chieftains, and they used to have in wars. I mean, they used to battle with each other. But then when the Europeans came along, they categorized the Africans according to the shades of their darkness of the skin, And this, they put them in three categories, darker, and darkest. Okay, or actually dark, less dark, and the least dark. And, this led to a great enmity between these three categories that were not actually prevalent before. This was made by the Europeans, and then they started fighting amongst each other, and this led to a huge amount of bloodshed and rivalry and everything. So what I'm thinking is, if there are rivalries, people need to first check, go to the background. Why is there a rivalry? What are we exactly fighting for?
Right.
Where did it all begin?
Yeah. No, I remember talking about this to one of my friends. Okay. And I'm not going to specify which countries and all that to avoid any conjecture here. But that friend was saying that there has been a rivalry between my country and this country forever. And he was saying how I love this artist, but this artist is from that country. So I will not love him. I'm like, but why not? And he's like, because his concept was my ancestors shed their blood for this, right? So why should I let it go futile? Now, in a way, I understand it, but in that sense also, you got to think about where your ancestors shedding their blood out of a logical thing or out of just some beliefs that were instilled in them, right? Like, for example, we know that rulers, most colonization, how was it done? It was divide and rule, right? It was easy to make people fight against each other. That's how a lot of politics works too. How they make people fight over each other so that the third person takes the cake, right? The two monkeys are fighting and the cat takes the cake or whatever animals those were. So there is an agenda why they do that. And now it's up to you whether you are smart enough to understand that, should I be fighting? Because, and I think that comes from ego. Logic goes down when your ego is speaking. But when you actually think logically, it makes no sense to do that. So, and I think the younger generation realizes it. The younger generation, not all of it, but a whole lot of younger people are more, I feel because of the internet and, how travel kind of expands the horizons, for this, the same way the internet or these shows that we watch, the world has become a smaller place, and that makes you think outside your little bubble and your box. And then that's why the younger generation is more progressive, because they are thinking, what is the point of all this? The world is so big. We do things this way and that country does things that way. So, there is more awareness in that sense. And that's why it's not like the younger generation doesn't appreciate traditions, but if they're not logical, then the younger generation is going to be why should I follow it?
True.
It's an important question to ask, why am I doing this?
Actually true. And I feel, it is evident, change is the only constant. So, change is inevitable and is a good thing, whether we like it or not. It is a good thing, and I think it's progress, and you need to finally accept it no matter what.
Right.
So that's the only way to move. You move forward, and moving forward is change.
Yeah, and the thing is, the funny thing is, the younger generation would care a lot about their parents, but if they oppose their parents, even in our traditions, right, in India, or I would presume even in Nigeria, if you say you disagree, You cannot respectfully disagree. It means you're disrespecting them. It means you don't love them. It means that you're just, you just think that they are worthless, you know? Like your parents are good. It means so many things to them, whereas you are just saying, I disagree with your opinion, respectfully. So it's just like, it doesn't mean that your kids don't love you at all or love you any less. It just means that they don't share the same perspectives. It's not indicative of anything. So, but those pressures are on kids, and those are very heavy pressures, right? And there's so many Hindi movies where the girl, like Dhadkan and many others, where the girl is in love with some guy and they're like, oh, he's a worthless guy, and the guy, and the dad gets a heart attack. Jeet, Dhadkan, many other movies where like, oh, I'm dying, and it's like, oh, it's your last wish, and then he doesn't die.
Oh, yes.
Yeah, then he's miraculously all good. It's like, oh, my sweet, obedient daughter, or whatever, whatever, you know.
Yeah.
I think that's also kind of like, it's interesting, and it's kind of funny to me. But, and also like the parents think that they're trying to do good. They don't think they're doing bad.
Yeah. I mean, the thing is, at any given point of time, a person himself would always feel that he's correct. So this goes for the parent, this goes for the child, this goes for the parent's parent, this goes for a 3-year-old, this goes for a 30-year-old and an 80-year-old. You're always thinking that I am right, and that evidently means the other person is wrong, because that person is not in agreement with you, right? But one thing which I did note and did like is that, you know, that couple, they're adults, they are already in love, but they still have this feeling that they want to, you know, persuade their parents to agree to their marriage. They're not just going all rebellious and saying, okay, we like each other, we're going to do this. So this is also something that is kind of endearing, because, you know, they could do that. Who could stop them, right? Who could stop them? I mean, there are ways to stop people, but in a sense, there is no one to stop them. But still, they want their parents to agree upon it. And they're fighting for it, they're struggling for it. That's lovely. That's, again, something that our cultures have something in common.
Yeah, my biggest takeaway from this is that Indian and Nigerian cultures are very similar in many, very many ways. You know, very, very community-based, very family-oriented, very traditional, as well as progressive. Like, there's all kinds of gamuts of movie trailers we have seen, right? Like, from very traditional stuff to very progressive, like, you know, like women in their 50s having younger lovers. Like, it's as diverse a society as Indian society is, more or less, I would think, you know. So it's very cool to see that Nigeria is so diverse, and there's so many wonderful stories to it, because the country itself is so interesting.
True. And, you know, another thing is, you said it reminded you of Namaste Vahala. Yes, it has that resonance. But what I would like to point out over here is that maybe for the parents, it is more forgivable if you bring a person from another country rather than a person who is an exact rival of yours. You know, that's completely unforgivable. That will not do.
Yeah, that's a very good point, because we see that in India as well, right? Like, some things are better than others. I'm not going to say what is what, but in India, right? So
True. That's
a very good point. Yeah. All right, guys. So if you liked our video, please subscribe to our channel and actually go ahead and give us a thumbs up. Also, hit that bell icon so that you're notified every time we upload a new video. We do that weekly on Mondays. Also, please leave us a comment to let us know how we're doing, or if there's anything else that we should be reviewing. Until next time, Firmalingi.
Firmalingi.